From New Jersey, Crash the Terminator. His opponent in this international match is weighing in at 245 pounds from Puerto Rico, Miguel Perez.
All right, Dutch and fans, and you heard it right there from Victor Quiñones, two of his top wrestlers. We're going to see him right here, Crash the Terminator and Miguel Perez. These are two of the top stars of the World Wrestling Council in Puerto Rico, and it's the first time that they've been on television in the United States, Dutch.
Well, it's the first for them. I'm sure they're real excited. Of course, any time anyone makes their debut on United States professional wrestling, televised wrestling, of course, they want to be successful. Miguel Perez, a little background on him, as only I know it, of course, a second-generation wrestler.
Just spill it out.
His father was a great wrestler in, like, in the 50s and the 60s. He was Miguel Perez Sr., might add. And Miguel, his real name is Miguelito. I'm bilingual, too, Bob Collar. But right now we see these two guys, the two big stars in the World Wrestling Council in Puerto Rico and also Japan, an organization called Wings. These men have wrestled all over the world. But I can't get over, you know, Arn Anderson. Now, where does Arn, let me ask you something. I don't mean to take away from this match or something, but I've just talked to Robert and Jimmy in the back. Mm-hmm. Arn Anderson, with the addition of Arn Anderson to the Rock and Roll Express, you know, that changes the equation quite significantly in this
six-man tag.
The Bluegrass Brawl in Pikeville, Kentucky on April 2nd. Now, they could have went out and got a lot of guys, but they got one of the toughest men in professional wrestling, Arn Anderson. Now, I'm not saying that everybody else in the ring's not tough, but he is a great addition to the rock and roll side on their part.
Well, this
I'll have to give them credit for that.
Well, you know, this comes up next weekend, and it's a combination of the five greatest teams of the past 10 years, Dutch. The Rock and Roll Express, the Midnight Express, the Heavenly Bodies, the Four Horsemen, and Eaton and Anderson.
Can now, wait a minute. Where's the Stud Stable? Why did you say that? The Stud Stable is also one of the greatest teams of
all
time.
Well, I guess I better make it six then.
Yeah, then put that in there. And that was a blatant, a prejudiced statement that you just made, and I took offense to it. If you're corrected, everything will be okay.
All right, we'll say six, Dutch. Look at that backflip coming off. Right over the big Terminator goes Miguel.
A big shot by Perez.
Perez coming off of the top rope. He caught that arm and went right with an arm drag off of the rope. That's an unusual move.
Yeah, vertical spinning arm drag is the name of it. That's a technical name.
That's a technical name. And you don't see it very often, do you, Dutch? A
couple elbows from the Terminator. Whoa!
Boy, that may turn his lights out. No, only a count of two.
Now you look at the Terminator, a big man. I don't know what they announced him. I didn't hear, but he looks like he's 260.
At least.
Maybe 270 inside that ring, and he looks like he's in shape.
Hey, Dutch, isn't that a sick set of rules that Kevin Sullivan designed for that Russian roulette death match? Evidently, we're not alone, as they've got problems with Sullivan, you heard earlier, in Puerto Rico and in Japan as well. You know, they're trying to ban him over there also. Well, I mean, everybody wants to get rid of Kevin Sullivan.
This is what I'm saying. You know, if he's so bad, you know, seems like they could do something about it, but he has used the judicial system. Now, is he using the judicial system in Japan also? Is he using it in Mexico also? If you have three separate international judicial systems that says you can't get rid of him, then obviously his case is very strong, I would add.
Well, I would add, Dutch, that he is evidently the same all over.
You know, let me tell you one thing, Bob. This is maybe something I shouldn't let out, but I made a trip with Kevin Sullivan not too long ago, and as I sat,
You got in the same vehicle with him?
Yes, I did. Because, see, I have to do that, Bob. I have to go behind the scenes to talk to some of these guys, and I can't just talk to them here. I got to get them, off to the side a little bit so I can have a one-on-one, build that rapport with them so they'll trust me so I can get down to the truth. And he made some very interesting comments, but he talked about, in the course of talking, he would lose his train of thought. And he
were they lucid comments?
Some of them were. And some of them were not lucid. And I got in there, and I intended to stay maybe 30, 45 minutes, but I sort of cut it a little bit short, maybe 15 minutes, and then I had to leave.
Wait a minute. Here comes Kevin Sullivan out. Wait a minute. Let me get in the microphone. Hold on just a minute.
What are these people doing talking about me? What are these people doing trying to persecute me? What are these people in Japan trying to take my living away? Who are these people that are after me. That's what I want to know. And why is that Brown LTD always following us? That's what I want to know. Hey, Connell, somebody tell me why these people are after me. Who do they think they are? What is this, an international match, huh?
Yeah, this
you
is
think
an
international.
It's an international
match. It's never international unless I'm there.
Wait a minute. Where is he going?
Kevin Sullivan.
There he goes. There goes Sullivan down in the ring. And he comes right in. The referee says, ring the bell. We got the Night Stalker. We got Sullivan in. We got them all in.
Well, what has happened? Kevin Sullivan is incensed that this Victor Quiñones came out of here from
Dutch
and did an interview about him.
Yeah.
And he's trying to ban him.
And there was a wild melee in there right now. The referee has said the match is over. The match is halted. Fans, let's get out of here. Let's see if we can get some order restored.